डर लक्ष्मण जी के दवा दुकान में मेन रोड गढ़ुआ, जहां प्रत्येक सोमवार के लालगढ़ हॉस्पिटल के छाला रोग विशेषज्ञ डॉक्टर के एन झा इस सब बीमारी के सफल इलाज कर रहल बानी।
याद रखी इहां पैथोलॉजी सेवा भी उपलब्ध बा, विशेष जानकारी खातिर
लक्ष्मण जी के दवा दुकान साहू मेडिसिन सेंटर मेन रोड गढ़ुआ।
हे भौजी, हे काहे मनवाल जी,
देखो ना अपने के भैया विदेश चले, कैसे मनाई ओहो में चूल्हे के आँच सुनुकतो न है, पिंड हो गई।
अच्छा तो ऐसा बात है, रेडियो मधेश मसला सुनो, मन हरिहर कर दिए।
हे तो तिंगा सुनाओ ता हाँ हे देवर जी, इतने साँचे के मन हरिहर कर देती हो।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द एफएम लिसनर्स ऑफ रेडियो मधेश मसला 106.4 मेगाहर्ट्ज़। इट्स मी सूरज नारायण झा इन द स्टूडियो विथ टेक फ्रेंड आरजे रविंद्र कुमार। वेलकम टू यू ऑल इन आवर रेडियो एजुकेशनल प्रोग्राम विच इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय नेपाल पुलिस स्कूल। एंड टुडे वी हैव इनवाइटेड my respected and your also respected Shankar Yadav sir in our studio for teaching English subject. Welcome sir.
Thank you.
Sir, are you fine?
Yes.
So you are going to start English subject, teaching the English subject.
Yes.
So please start our class and I will be right back at the end of the program.
Okay. Thank you. Good morning to you all, those who are watching and listening this radio educational program. This is a great opportunity for us to broadcast this program for the students to get the benefit of the education during this widespread pandemic coronavirus. Even if it is not as effective as the classroom teaching and learning, but it is very good for all of the students. So I hope that you will enjoy this class. Today, I have got the opportunity to teach the students of class 2 English subject, and it is of the grammar, unit 2. In unit 2, there is nouns. So let me teach you what is noun. In one words, we can say noun is a naming word. Noun is a naming word. There are many things around us. Everything has their name. There is nothing without a name. Everything carries their name. So naming word is a noun. Noun is the name of a person, place, things, animals, and birds. Today I am going to teach you about the common noun and proper noun in detail. Common noun Common noun and proper noun. Now look at these sentences. Here are two sentences. I am a Pemba and I am a boy. Both sentences have the name. Pemba and boy. In both sentences, you can see here is a Pemba, it is the name of a person. Here is a boy, this is also the name of a person. Here, Pemba is a name of a particular person, only one person. In the same way, boy is a sharing name that is generally used by all boy of the world. So, this is the common noun and Pemba is the proper noun. Please be careful about this. Common noun. Common noun is the name that is given to every person, every place, every things, every animals. This is the sharing name. This name is generally used by all, not only one person, used by all. In the same way, proper noun is a special noun that is used by a single person, only one person. I can give you another example. Now look here at this sentence. I live in a city. Its name is Rajviraj. Here in both sentences there are names. City is a name and Rajviraj is a name. Now here, city is a common noun because it is generally used by all the town and city. It is not a name of a particular one. It is the name of all, it is generally used by all. This is the sharing name. In the same way, Rajviraj is the name of a particular place. So this is the proper noun of a place. So city is the common noun, whereas Rajviraj is the proper noun. And remember one thing. Proper noun always starts with the capital letter. That is the speciality of the proper noun. I can give you another example. My brothers. Name is Pukar. Here we can underline the name brother and Pukar. These are the name of a person. One of them is the common noun, whereas another is the proper noun. So here, Pukar is the proper noun. Whereas, brother is the common noun. name is given to every person. But this name is given to only one person. So the name which is given to only one person is the proper noun, whereas the names which is given to every person, all person, is the common noun. So in short, you can say noun is the naming word. That is the main point. Naming word that gives the name to everything. Whatever the things you see around you have the name, they bear the name. There is nothing without name. And common noun, in one word you can say sharing name. The name that is shared by not one person but many person. Every person, every place, everything, every bird, every animals. That is the common noun. Means sharing name. Sharing name. That is generally used by not a single person or place or thing or animal, but many. Now proper noun. Proper noun is a particular noun that is given to a single person. A special noun. It is a special noun. And this special noun is not shared by all or more than one person. A special noun is the name of a particular person, place, thing, animal, birds. And common noun is the noun which is given to every person, place, thing, animal, and birds. Now let me make you clear about this thing in detail. Or now look at this sentence. Or her village name is Garuda. Garuda. In this sentence, here are two nouns. Village. It is the name of a place. In the same way, Garuda is also the name of a place. What is the difference between them? Village is the name which is given to every village across the world. Whereas, Garuda is the name of a place which is the particular one. This name is given to a particular place, not to all. So here village is the common noun. Whereas, Garuda is the proper noun, or you can say special noun. Proper noun, common noun. Be clear about this once again. Village is the name of a place in this sentence. In the same way, Garuda is also the name of a place. place. But what is difference between them? Village is the name which is given to every village across the world. Garuda is also the name of a place which is given to a particular village, not all villages across the world. I hope that you may have been clear about this idea. Now it's time for a break. And I will be back very soon after this break. Now your homework. Your homework is fill this chart. I'm going to make a chart and you have to fill this as your homework. Turn over the page of your book 28 of your Maxim Grammar of class 2, and you can find there is a chart like this. And in this chart there is the proper nouns given and common nouns are given in a box, and you can choose the common nouns for each proper nouns from the box and do this exercise in your back home. Thank you for watching and listening this program patiently. Bye bye.
रेडियो मधेस मसला 106.4 मेगाहर्ज में अब समय है व्यापारिक विश्राम के। तब तक अपने भी हाथ साबुन पानी से मल मल के धो के आओ। कोरोना वायरस से अपने भी बचो आ दूसरों के बचाओ।
हातमा पंजा मुखमा मास्क लगाई चश्मा आँखामा राष्ट्रको सेवा हेतु खट्दछौं हामी सीमा नाका नाकामा सीमा नाका नाकामा कसै गरी नछुनु हेर आँखा नाक अनि मुख कोरोनाबाट जोगिन सके आउने छ सबै सुख आउन सक्छ बाढी र पहिरो चल्न सक्छ हुरी खटिदा ड्युटी कायम राखौं सामाजिक दूरी कर्तव्यको बोधबाट छैन विमुख कुनै पनि पल चुनौतीको सामना गर्न तत्पर हामी हौ सशस्त्र प्रहरी बल हामी हौ सशस्त्र प्रहरी बल
सशस्त्र प्रहरी बल नेपाल नम्बर 2 छिन्नमस्ता वाहिनी मुख्यालय महोत्तरी द्वारा जारी सन्देश
सूचना 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 कोरोना भाइरस संक्रमण सम्बन्धी अत्यन्त जरुरी सूचना हाल विश्व भर फैल रहल कोरोना वायरस से नेपाल उच्च जोखिम में रहल विश्व स्वास्थ्य संगठन के प्रतिवेदन अनुसार कोरोना वायरस से हो रहल आ हो सके वाला संभावित जोखिम से बचेला कोनो किस्म के सभा जुलूस मेला आदि न करे न करावे के लेल अनुरोध कैल जायत है। कोरोना वायरस से बचे वाला उपाय भीड़ से बचो, चले के समय मास्क के प्रयोग करो, साबुन पानी से नियमित हाथ धो, कम पाकल मांस मछली न खाओ, दही दूध घी पनीर आदि के सेवन करो, सरल खाए वाला चीज न खाओ, खाए वाला चीज के नीमन से धो के आ अच्छा से पका के मात्र खाओ, एक आपस में अभिवादन कैला पर नमस्ते करो, हाथ न मिलाओ, एक आपस में शारीरिक दूरी कायम रखो, खोखला पर या छींक आयला पर अगाड़ी के व्यक्ति के विपरीत दिशा में अपन मुख छुपू रोग संक्रमण लागल संख्या लगला में स्वास्थ्य तथा रोग नियंत्रण कार्यालय के कॉल सेंटर नंबर 1339 में जानकारी दियो तथा चिकित्सक संगे संपर्क करो दैनिक रूप में पानी गर्म करके मात्र प्रयोग करो ब्रॉडकास्टिंग एसोसिएशन ऑफ नेपाल आ रेडियो मधेश मसला गौड़ा द्वारा जनहित में जारी संदेश
रेडियो मधेश मसला 106.4
You are watching and listening this radio educational program. Now I have come back after the short break for class 3 to teach English subject. It's me, Shankar Yadav. This unit is related to the previous unit that I have already taught for class 2 before the break time. Nouns. Today I am going to teach you about the singular and plural noun. First of all, look at some words and try to know the words which are the plural by their plural marking. Boys, banana, mangoes, book, pen, benches, knives. Now look at these words. There are both singular and plural nouns. So how can you know that which one is singular and which one is plural? So there is the plural marking that tells us this one is the plural noun. Plural marking is yes, 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 yes. So plural markers are here, yes, plural marker. Plural marker that tell us or help us to know the singular and plural noun easily are yes, 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 yes. These are the plural marker. Now let me tell you about the nouns. Nouns have two numbers. They are singular and plural. The word which refers to only one in number is singular noun. And the noun which refers to more than one in number is plural noun. Let me tell you once again. The noun or the word that refers to or tell us only one in number is the singular noun. Only one in number is the singular noun. And the noun that refers to more than one in number means many is the plural noun. Many. One, singular. More than one, noun, many. Many, plural. So, dear student, if there is only one person, place, thing, animal, they are singular noun. If there is more than one person, place, thing, animal, or birds, they are plural. So, here are some words to tell you which one is singular and which one is plural, and after that I will teach you how to change the singular into plural. What are the rules to form the singular into plural? Before that, let me give you some example to know which one is singular and which one is plural. Cat, dogs, plates, copy, benches, glasses, pencil, rubber, birds, king, pants. Now here are some words in the box. Now you can identify which one is the singular and which one is the plural. And before identifying, you can remember the plural markers that I have taught you. These are the plural markers: S, ES, VES, IES. The words which are plural have the plural markers at the last of it, at the end of the word. The plural words have these plural markers at the end of it. So, find it here. Where is yes, ES, VES or IES in these words at the end? So, look here, dogs. Here, yes is here, so it is plural. It is plural. Plates, here is also yes, plural. Copy, there is not the plural marker, so it is not plural, it is singular. In cat, there is no plural marker like yes, es, ves or ies, so it is singular. In benches, you can see here, here is the plural marker es, so this is plural. Are you getting me? Please, get clearly. In glasses, you can see the plural marker ES at the end of the word. So this is also plural. In pencil, you cannot find out the plural marker ES, IES, VES or ES. So it is singular. Pencil is singular here. In rubber, we can't find those plural markers. So it is also singular. In birds, we can certainly find the plural marker, yes, so it is plural. In king, the word king, we cannot get any plural marker, s, es, ves, or ies, so king is here singular, not plural. In vans, vehicle, transport, you can see here, there is the plural marker at the end of the word vans. So, vans is also here, plural. So, I hope that you guys may have learned how to find out the plural and singular easily. Now, let me teach you how to change the singular into plural. There are some rules to change the singular into plural. Let me highlight once again about the singular noun and plural noun. Singular noun means the noun that refers to one. Only one in number is the singular noun. For example, a boy. Here, a boy means only one boy. But here, plural noun means the noun which refers to more than one in number is plural noun. For example, boys. Boys means not only one boy. Many boys, more than one boys. That's why this is the plural. Boys is plural, whereas a boy is singular. Because a boy refers to only one number. That's why it is the singular. And here, boys means this noun refers to more than one boys. That's why this is plural. Now, let me teach you how to change the singular noun into plural. What are the rules to form the singular noun into plural? Forming plurals. In forming plurals, we use the plural marker at the end of the singular noun. These plural markers are used at the end of the AP word to be plural. So let's see which word takes the plural marker yes only. So the word having B, B sound, D, the sound, G, G sound, cock, ball, room, van, cap, car, cat, car. Now look at these words. These words are singular. Now how to form these words into plural? It is very easy. Take the plural marker, yes, for these words. The words having B letter at the last, D letter at the last, G letter at the last, K letter at the last, L letter at the last, M letter at the last, W letter at the last, N letter at the last, P, T takes plural marker S. So we can add S here and we can make cops. Now it became plural. In this way, we can change the singular into plural. Bed, beds. Remember one thing. The words having these letters at the last, B, B, D, G, K, L, M, W, N, P, R, T, always takes the plural marker S. Now, let me teach you which word or singular noun takes the plural marker yes. The word having S, CH, yes, yes, X, O, takes E प्लुरल मार्कर ईएस। प्लीज फिक्स योर अटेंशन हियर एंड दोज आर लिसनिंग, लिसन वेरी केयरफुली। द वर्ड हैविंग दीज लेटर्स एट द एंड ऑफ इट, एस सी एच एस एस एक्स ओ, टेक्स द प्लुरल मार्कर ईएस। Now let me give you an example. B-U-S, bus. Here, bus is the singular noun, and you can see in this word bus, what is the last letter? Yes, S is the last letter. So when there is the S at the end of a singular noun, then use the plural marker E-S. So B-U-S-E-S, buses. Now it became plural. In the same way, now you can take the word having the letter C-H at the last is B-E-N-C-H, bench. Here you can see the word bench has the last two letters C-H. And this word take the plural marker E-S. B-E-N-C-H-E-S, benches. In the same way, now you can see another word, G-L-A-S-S, glass. The word having S-S letter at the end takes plural marker E-S. G-L-A-S-S-E-S, glasses. And I would like to add one more that is left, SH also. SH, the word having SH at the end also takes the plural marker ES. Now, bus, tall grass. Here in the word bus, you can see the last two letter is SH. And it takes the plural marker ES. Buses. In the same way, now you can see another word, box, B-O-X, box. In this word, last letter is X. So the word having the X letter at the end takes the plural marker E-S, B-O-X-E-S, boxes. In the same way, now you can see here, potato. The word potato has the O letter at the end of it. So it also takes the plural marker ES. Potatoes. The student, listen once again very carefully. The word having these letters at the last takes the plural marker ES. The word having last letter SH, S, CH, SS, X, and O always takes the plural marker ES to be plural from the singular. So these are the rules to change the singular noun into plural. Now let me teach you another rule to form the singular into plural. The word having Y letter at the last. The word having Y letter at the last always takes IES. If there is consonant letter before the Y, then it takes or it changes into IES. if there is consonant letter before Y, then Y is removed and IES takes place. So let me give you an example of the word which have the letter Y. B-A-B-Y, baby. Here you can see in the noun, singular noun, baby, the last word, the end of the word, end of the letter here is Y. At the end of the word, Y is here, and before the Y, you can see here is the consonant letter B. So in this case, Y is removed and IES is added. B, A, B. Now remove the Y. Remove the Y. Cut the Y and add the IES, babies. Let me give you another word as an example. How to change the word having the Y letter at the end. Sky. Here at the end of the word you can see Y is here, and before the Y you can see here consonant letter is K. So in this case we can remove the Y and add the IES. Yes, K I E S, skies. Fly, F L Y, fly. In the word fly there is also Y at the last. So remove the Y, add the IES. Flies. Dairy. In the word dairy, there is also Y letter at the end of it. So, and before the Y, there is consonant letter R. So in this case, remove the Y and add the IES. D-A-I-R I-E-S. Dairies. Now let me teach you another rule. The word having the Y letter, but if there is vowel letters before the Y letter, in that case we do not remove the Y, we generally use S. Y is not changed into IES. In which case, if there is vowel letter, if there is vowel letter before the Y, before the Y, in this case we do not remove the Y, we just add the S. We do not add the IES. We do not add the IES. We do not add IES. We add only S. In which case? If there is vowel letter before the Y. Let me give you an example through the word B-O-Y, boy. Here you can see in the word boy, the last letter is Y, of course, but before the Y here is O. That is vowel letter. Before the Y, here is vowel letter O. So we cannot remove the Y. We just add the S to form the plural noun of the boy. B-O-Y-S. Don't remove the Y. In the same way, I can give you another example of the same rule, D-A-Y, day. Here you can see in this word, singular, last letter is Y, but before the Y, there is vowel letter A. In this case, we do not remove the Y, but we add the S. Dates.
Sir, due to the scarcity of time, now this time to leave from here. So please assign the homework for the students, sir.
Thank you. Now, dear student, I am going to give you some homework to do. Change these words into plural. HW, or you can see the page of your syntax book of class 3, 33. You can do all exercises of number A. Do all the exercises of A.
So write at least 5 questions from the book.
Question.
Yes.
Okay, dear student, get the homework. Do all the exercises of A, B, and C of the page number 33 of your syntax grammar. And along with this, I would like to give you some question. You can write, what is singular noun? What is singular noun? What is plural noun? What is noun? This homework is enough for today.
Okay, thank you, sir. Dear all the listeners of Radio Madhes Masala 106.4 MHz, we are here for radio educational program sponsored by Nepal Police School and media partner Radio Madhes Masala 106.4 MHz. Thank you, sir, for coming here and dealing about the subject matter of class 2 and 3. And what do you want to tell the student about the COVID-19, sir?
Thank you, technician, sir, for your kind cooperation.
Thank you, sir.
Dear student, at last, before wrapping up the program, I would like to suggest you take the right advantage of the time during this widespread, devastating coronavirus, which is really terror for all of us. Stay safe in your home. Wherever you go, please put on the mask. Use your mask. Thank you.
And if possible, use sanitizer. If not possible, use soap and water for washing your hand. Thank you, sir, for coming here. Now the time to leave from here. So before leaving, I would like to thank RJ Kumar Sandan for technical support. And I would like to thank Sankar Yadav, sir, for coming here. And this is the time of epidemic COVID-19, so be safe, use mask, use sanitizer if possible. If not possible, use soap and water. Thank you. Take care.